Welcome, everybody. Welcome to Music at Midday from St. John's Episcopal Church, to those of you here in the church and to those of you listening online from all over. This is the last performance of today's sixth season. We will have one extra Music at Midday performance featuring some patriotic music on Saturday, July 3rd. That's Independence Day weekend, so we'll announce more information about that, but that'll be probably closer to an hour as we did last year. And that was our most watched recital of 2020, about 1,200 views in a couple days. So we'll be glad to add that again. We hope you'll take note that choral evensong on Sundays at 5:30 is now offered in person. So we hope you would consider making a reservation by contacting Diana Carter, as you probably did to come today. So, or you can continue to join us online for that. And you can find music lists for that service on our website as well. I'd like to thank all of our Music Society donors for giving so generously that we can offer this and so much of what we do. And I hope you brought a sense of humor with you today for today's recital featuring The King of Instruments by William Albright. You'll hear readings describing various keyboards and the pedal board and various stops of the organ, and it's really fun, I think. So I hope you'll enjoy the performance. We'll see you at the end, and please join me now in welcoming our narrator, Scott Cantrell.
With keys of plum and palisander, the organist unlocks the music in the box that takes the name of king. He makes the bellows sing the while he lets his hands meander, inventing combinations grander than any played by Alexander's trumpets flourishing. The manuals are keyboards thrice, stacked great, positive, and swell. The way up leads to paradise. The way down leads to hell. Thank you. Here come the pedals, flaunting their metals. With boots on their feet, they stride to the beat. They parade through the day. They tramp through the night, secure on their way in columns so tight. When they move in a line, they step out so fine. But when making a leap, watch out, they fall in a heap. The flues. Blues. The swarming mixtures, buzzing, whirring, flies and bees, mosquitoes, whining their song, black clouds of locusts threatening with metallic music, spot their victims and swoop. Greedy flute is on the go. He takes his time, his nibble slow. He's not in haste, he treasures taste. He eats the bread, he eats the meat, and every morsel is a treat. He eats the silver and the plate. He takes the crystal glasses straight. He eats the flowers and the napery, and if near enough, the drapery. He slurps the water from the jug and then disposes of the rug. He reads his navel and the chairs. He even eats the marble stairs. He gobbles up the hardwood floor, then turns around and yells for more. The principal above the scene, disdainful, distant, calm, serene. He rears his crest, he flaunts his sheen, careful each separate plume to preen. Down the street came a Sesquialtera, like a floozy with too much mascara. When I said, "Name your vice," she said, "Better think twice. I'm descended from Scarlet O'Hara." The reeds have a creed. If you want to succeed, try anger and clangor, then tie on some speed. The Clarion needs Marion. The Faggott does not. Have you ever heard a gamba do a red-hot Latin samba? For a heaven-sent two-rank celeste. With devotion and prayer, this twin seems obsessed. Though many stops swear that they've courted this pair, the celeste insists incest's best. Over the keys his fingers dance, across the pedals his tootsies prance. He huffs and puffs, he frets and sweats, up and down the bench he slides, as over the beastie he presides. He rips his seam, his girdle pops, at last he's pulled out all the stops.